A local fan who met the King of Pop several times was also at today's memorial, and she talked to Amy Wagner about her experience. It's our number two story, Amy.
Well, Sheree, here in the tri-state, many people gathered down here on Fountain Square to watch a historic memorial on the big screen, but there was one local woman who watched the memorial from just a few feet away from the stage.
Just to be there, I have to be there.
That's what lifelong Michael Jackson fan Jenny Winings told us last week, and she was there today, watching Michael Jackson's memorial at the Staples Center.
We were sitting on the floor right in front of the stage.
And from there, Jenny says she witnessed one of the most moving, emotional events of her life.
When Jermaine sang Smile, when Usher sang Gone Too Soon, because Michael actually wrote that for Ryan White, who died of AIDS. And then, of course, his daughter.
The same images that move those who gathered on Fountain Square to watch today's memorial on the big screen.
I feel very overwhelmed.
Many still in shock that the man who provided the soundtrack for their lives is now silent.
Never ever imagined that it would come to this, that I would ever witness this day.
A sentiment shared by one of Michael Jackson's biggest fans, forced to say goodbye long before she expected to.
It was just us saying goodbye to somebody that we truly loved and cared about.
And today, another tri-state man who knew Michael Jackson very well saying goodbye. Marvin Butts was actually Jackson's bodyguard on three of his tours. I spoke with him on the phone tonight. He said he was moved by today's memorial, that so many other people remembered him as he did. A fun-loving, giving, shy man who actually happened to be a brilliant entertainer. Reporting live tonight, I'm Amy Wagner, News 5.